I don't think that sperm motility, morphology, and count, those standard semen parameters, are accurate tools to diagnose infertility. They are more laboratory findings than a diagnosis itself. So there need to be extensive semen analysis to detect the underlying causes that result in male infertility. Is the current standard sufficient to diagnose male urogenital tract inflammation and infection? No, not at all. We are using a method from the last century. It's not accurate. There are far more and better techniques to detect inflammation, just like flow cytometry, for instance. I have the feeling that in medicine per se, most disciplines are using better techniques that is comparable with a cell phone or a smartphone, while in andrology, we are still using the telephone booth with the rotary dial. And this has to change. And a lot of labs are using flow cytometry, but it's not a standard yet. And if you take into account that up to 15% of cases associated with subfertility or infertility in males are associated or due to infection and inflammation, we have to correct our standard method to detect or diagnose these conditions. Male infertility diagnostic will be headed in the future into automated systems. Also, extensive semen analysis, apart from sperm count, motility, and morphology, the immune system of the male, and disturbances within the immune system, but also other aspects that include lifestyle, include genetics. So there's more to discover in andrology and male subfertility, and we have a lot of stuff to do.